which have actually led to this move. Rahul Patwardhan from NIIT is with us to talk about their earnings. Rahul, hi, good afternoon. What a fabulous quarter. Tell us what's actually led to this kind of growth.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's the plans that we laid out at the beginning of the year, and as we laid out from 2.5 years back, we're just executing to plan. As we said, in quarter three, we had an unfortunate blip resulting due to external circumstances that we're all familiar with. But we had promised that we would get back to growth track in all our businesses. SNC was the one that was affected last quarter. SNC has added 3% growth in quarter four and a 4% EBITDA. Which is very much in line with what we had said. The CLG business has done extremely well. We had a substantial growth of 51% in the quarter. I must, however, highlight that part of it was due to a significant strategic sourcing deal that we got from one of our existing customers. This is not something we should project as a 51% going forward, but it's a very good result. It also shows the trust that customers place in us in terms of the quantum of business that we can get. We had a number of new deals in this quarter. As you know, we announced a very, very large deal in Canada, the Real Estate Corporation of Ontario. The predecessor, who was the incumbent, was earning about 30 million Canadian dollars per year from this contract. We are in a consortium, and our share would be roughly half of the revenue that comes from there. So it's a pretty substantial deal. But we also had another deal with a very major global aviation firm. We also had three more deals that were actually inked in, but not yet contracted. So the contracting is going on, but we've already started work on those. All these three are in the top two in their respective industries worldwide. We also had two renewals of two of our very major customers. So very, very powerful and strong quarter from the corporate business. The schools business also did extremely well. This is the most important quarter for the schools business because they make their sales before the school terms start. We've had a 49% growth in our go-forward business in the school sector. We added 392 schools in this quarter, which is a 221% increase over the number of schools we added last year in the same quarter. Our EBITDA has jumped up by triple digits in this quarter compared to last year in the schools business. So overall, very healthy quarter. The teams worked extremely hard. We did feel a little disheartened in quarter three, but we pulled together, and I think the hard work and the strategy and working to plan has demonstrated results.
Yeah, it sure has. Your corporate learning group has surprised in growth as well as visibility. Would you say that this was a function of faster execution and ramp up, or was it about bigger client signings?
Yeah, as I mentioned, strategic sourcing is a business where we manage a procurement of a customer from all third parties related to training, which may be things that they do with other companies, but we manage it on their behalf. So the potential revenue from that business can be very large. We have not taken that much business because we don't wish to have too much pass-through revenues. But in this quarter, on the request customers, we actually took in a lot more of that business. And this is very fast turnaround business, and that has contributed. But in addition to that, it's the fact that we have been building up a customer base, our pipeline's been growing stronger, and therefore we were able to get additional revenues in the quarter.
Okay, and how has been the recovery in the skills and career division, especially post demonetization, and what's the outlook going forward?
Yeah, the recovery has been good. We're back to where we wanted to be in this quarter. I do want to highlight that our DigiNex curriculum exceeded all our internal targets in terms of enrollments for the full year. And that's very important because that's the main plank of our growth strategy going forward. You read the newspapers, so everything in the papers are about the whole issue of digital reskilling in the existing IT workforce, as well as the IT arms of all other companies, not just the IT services companies, but the IT departments of any company in any sector has to be digitally reskilled. The university system is struggling with servicing that need because they are not equipped to deliver digital skills training. And young people, engineers, are looking for jobs, and the job market is not moving as fast as they would like to, not just in IT, but in other sectors. So there's a perfect storm of opportunity for NIIT with the fact that we have built a curriculum that is exactly suited to what the market needs for us to capitalize on. And this year, I think, will be the big year, having proven our base in FY17.
All right, Mr. Patwardhan, just closing comments from you. You know, FY17 was about sustainability, about ensuring profitable growth. What can we expect from you in terms of growth in FY18?
Yeah, in terms of guidance, our corporate business, we continue to hold to our 15-plus top-line growth. 12% EBITDA was the guidance that we've been giving for the profit or for this business. We'll be moving to the new Ind AS accounting system from 1st April. Ind AS accounting system has some implications on the way revenue is stated and the way certain costs are stated. That will result in our revenue going down, but our EBITDA percentage increasing substantially in the corporate business. Right now, the Ind AS accounting process is going on, so I can't give you a very definite number. But you can say that a 15% top line growth and a 12 plus Ind AS impact is what we're looking at. In the skills and career business, we are looking at a growth rate of single digits on the top line, and our EBITDA also would be in the mid to high single digits. The schools business will continue to grow at least 15 to 20% for the go-forward business, which is excluding our government schools business and our asset-based business that we don't sell anymore. And our EBITDA should move closer to a double digit from the current 5% that it has reported for FY17. So overall, all the businesses will be tracking up. And most important, there will be no business within the NIIT portfolio which will have any red ink on the bottom line. And not even a sub-business would have red ink on the bottom line.
Okay, Rahul, great speaking with you. And congratulations on an excellent last quarter with NIIT. I understand this is your last one. So what's the plan going forward? Where do we see you next?
Well, as you know, my reason for leaving NIIT is not for any other reason except that I want to be back with my family in Singapore. So I'll be moving back to Singapore, and I have a number of things that I'm looking at. When the time comes, I'm sure I will be communicating that.
Okay, great. Singapore is a lovely city. Enjoy being back with your family. I'm sure it's going to be great for you. Good speaking with you as always. NIIT Technologies,
Thank you very much.
Currently reacting to its positive earnings, 7% higher for NIIT as we speak, 90 plus levels for NIIT. Well, that's the case with the market as well. The headline number sure is impressive, so we made it back to that fresh high. 95.20 is where we're currently at for the index, and it's nudged back into the green, or at least trying to. So for the small cap index as well, mid caps too have lifted off from the lows of the day. Still early days, let's see which way this market actually heads. Today we've largely spent consolidating at that 9500 mark. Take a quick break on that note.
Oh yes, we'll take a quick break, and of course we'll be connecting with the management of DHFL, so don't go anywhere.